What is up guys, and welcome to yet another video. Today we are here in Kochi, and we are here because Hotel Forte Kochi and Kumarkom Lake Resort have invited us to stay at their properties. And in this video, I'm going to share my experiences and impressions about this Hotel Forte Kochi and exploring the area around it. So we left Mumbai at 11 o'clock and we have just checked into this place.
This flight is in conjunction with Turkish Airlines, our codeshare partner. It is now ready for departure. The flying time to Kochi is 1 hour and 35 minutes.
So there are two ways in which you can reach Fort Kochi area from the Cochin International Airport. And while we are on the topic of the airport, Cochin International Airport is the first airport in the world that completely runs on solar energy. I think that is amazing, and all airports should do the same thing as well. So the first way of reaching Fort Kochi is via the highway, which is obviously shorter but not that scenic. And there's a second route which takes you through this area called as Vaipin, where you take your car onto the ferry and they make you cross the water body to reach Fort Kochi. And as you guys already know, I prefer the more scenic route, even if it's going to take a lot more time. And उसके बाद we have just checked in, and I'm just giving you an update on आगे हम लोग क्या करने वाले हैं. The check-in process was very quick. Arrival पे वो लोग ने हम लोग को एक cold towel दिया था, जिसका बहुत ज़रूरी था, because अभी गर्मी बहुत है यहाँ पे. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, I'm going to give you a room tour, and उसके बाद we are going to be heading out to explore the area nearby. Before we get started, you need to know a little bit of background about Fort Kochi, because it really influences the entire feel and vibe of this hotel. Kochi was initially a very small fishing village, and the name Kochi was actually given by the Chinese, because when they came here they found it like China, and that is why they named it Kochi, which means like China in Mandarin. And after that it was ruled by the Raja of Kochi before the Portuguese arrived in 1503. The Portuguese ruled and remained in this area for 160 years before they were overthrown in 1683 by the Dutch. The Dutch also stayed here for 112 years before the British took control over the Dutch. So as history tells us, this area has been passed down from the Portuguese to the Dutch to the British and now currently Indians. That is why this area is so unique in India, as it has its influence from the Dutch, the Portuguese, the British and Indian cultures. This fusion of different cultures can be seen in the architecture, the layout, the way in which the entire area is built. This was super interesting, and this kind of mixture is so rare to find in India. And that is what makes this place so unique. The hotel is this beautiful yellow building with very European architecture, which has been renovated into a boutique hotel. Previously it was a home that has been converted into a hotel. The bedrooms are now rooms. The large courtyard serves as the common swimming and the lounge area. The living room has been converted into a reception and the main dining area, and everything has a very European feel to it. The best part about this hotel is the location. It is so centrally located that all major tourist attractions are literally 5 to 15 minutes walk away. And I think that is what made it possible for me to explore Fort Kochi in just one day. I simply fell in love with the entire look and feel of this entire place. Be it the yellow walls, the retro flooring, the tiles, the tinted glasses, an old staircase for taking you to the first floor. Everything was so unique, and yet the place had all the comforts of a luxury 5-star hotel. There are basically 3 room categories, the difference being in space, amenities and obviously the cost. The night that we stayed, the management had arranged for a cultural show in the courtyard, where talented musicians played classical music while we enjoyed our candlelight dinner by the pool. Special mention to the food here, it is by far one of the best Keralian food that I have ever had, and trust me, I have had my fair share of Keralian food, as my boarding school was very nearby in Coimbatore. We asked the manager to just surprise us and serve us the best local food that a chef could make, and surprise us they did. The Kerala paratha, the appam and the stew were beyond words. The flavor of coconut and spices were perfectly balanced with the chewiness of the bread. It was simply delicious. A special note for the staff, who were very helpful and very thoughtful. They had arranged for transportation, and they gave me some really nice suggestions and local secrets on where to go and how to explore the place like a local. And now that is my kind of travel. And if you guys want to stay at this place, I'm going to leave a link to their booking page in the description box below, so feel free to check that out after you see this video. So now that I have showed you the hotel, it's time to go outside and explore the places nearby. I have also made an interactive map that shows you the best places to see, the things to do, and I will leave a link to that in the description box below. Like I said before, everything is in just walking distance from the hotel. So once we're out of the hotel, the first place we go is the Chinese fishing nets. And this technique of catching fish is still used by the fishermen here, and I must say it is highly effective. And the best time to go here is during the sunset, because the local fishermen are fishing, people are just walking around having a good time, children are playing, and all the shops are out there for you to do some shopping. It can get a little bit crowded, but the view from here is really nice and it is the perfect place to enjoy the sunset in Fort Kochi. After you're done with the promenade, go to the Dutch Cemetery, the St. Francis Church, which are all in walking distance and are really nice and interesting places to see in Fort Kochi. And after St. Francis Church, coming to my favorite building in Fort Kochi is the Santa Cruz Basilica. Once you're done with the Basilica, you can go down to the Jewish town. The Jewish town is not walkable distance, so you can take a tuk-tuk or a rickshaw, which will cost you 100 rupees one way. Once you're there, the Jewish town is really interesting, as it has some really awesome shops where you can get some spices, some handicrafts, some really nice pashminas, and some really old artifacts as well. And I think it is a perfect place for you to take some souvenirs back home for your friends and family. So if you have a day in Kochi, these 6 places are a must visit, and they really show you the history and the background of this beautiful place. And in the evening, when you're tired, after you've walked around all these places, head to many beer gardens which serve chilled beer and wine along with snacks. The streets of Fort Kochi are lined with such beautiful places, and just walk into any of them to round up the evening. And if you want more information about this place, I have a dedicated blog about this topic as well. I will leave a link to my blog in the description box below, so feel free to check it out. So that brings us to the end of today's vlog. It was a very tiring day, but honestly bahut maza aa gaya. If you guys like this video, subscribe to my channel, share it with your travel friends, and don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Tell me what you thought about this video in the comment section below, and don't forget to tune in next week. Hum log kal ja rahe hai Kumarkom Lake Resort, and I'm sure it is going to be awesome. And until the next time, keep on traveling, and don't forget to press that bell icon so that you can be notified whenever I upload a video just like this.